Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol CRMD. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 30 minutes. So while this here may look like several days worth of time, it's actually today's price action broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like to do this time frame, and it's a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price, and then makes mapping out levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. I've done this analysis several times in the past. That's where the red and green line annotations are coming from. But after today's price movement, definitely some updates here need to be made. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually just a little house cleaning and go ahead and delete these lines out of here. Sure, they still pertain to the chart. They're just not relevant. And from a presentation standpoint, I don't want to risk causing clutter and confusion because there's lines all over the place. So I want to try to keep this as clean as possible. The first update that needed to be done comes about based on a foundational rule in charting, which states when levels of resistance are broken and closed above, you want to see them act as support. So going into today, $1.65 was an area of resistance, but now that the price is up above it, that would be considered one of the newest areas of support. The ideal level of support going forward, when you say, hey Clay, what would make this chart look the absolute strongest going forward? That would be if the price can stay up above $1.77. Now, with that being said, if the price falls below $1.77, I'm not saying the entire chart's ruined or anything like that. But yeah, if the price can somehow manage to actually stay up above that level, that would certainly be a huge sign of strength going forward. Taking a step back, looking at things from the big picture point of view, it's still all about the purple line right there, the 50 period simple moving average. Keyword being moving, as time goes by, this line here is going to move itself higher and higher. So as long as the price stays above that purple line, as the line itself moves higher and higher, then the bulls are in full health, the bulls are in full control. How are you going to best visualize that? You know, that's what's being represented. Again, yeah, staying above $1.77, that would be great. But from the grand scheme of it all, as long as the price continues to stay above that purple line, the bulls 100% own the chart. As far as levels of resistance, I'm not even going to touch on those because in my opinion, top priority right now is just building higher bases, because as longer term holders have seen, as long as higher bases continue to be built, everything else takes care of itself, including breaking levels of resistance. So focus on healthy consolidations and building those higher lows, and then you can just sit back and let the trend do its thing. One of the biggest questions I get is, hey Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.